This is the story of Peter and the Wolf. Each character in the story will be represented by a different instrument in the orchestra. See if you can figure out which instruments represent each character. Are you sitting comfortably? Then I shall begin. Early one morning, Peter opened the gate and went out into the big green meadow. Branch of a big tree sat a little bird, Peter's friend. All is quiet," chirped the bird gaily. Quiet. Just then, a duck came waddling around. She was glad that Peter hadn't closed the gate and decided to take a nice swim in the deep pond in the meadow. Suddenly, something caught Peter's attention. It was a cat crawling through the grass. Just then, Grandfather came out. He was angry because Peter had gone in the meadows. "It is a dangerous place. If a wolf had come out of the forest, then what would you do?" But Peter paid no attention to his grandfather's words. Boys like Peter aren't afraid of wolves. Grandfather took Peter by the hand, locked the gate, and led him home. Peter gone, then a big gray wolf came out of the forest. Twinkling, the cat climbed up into the tree. The duck quacked, and in her excitement, jumped out of the pond. But no matter how hard the duck tried to run, she couldn't escape the wolf. He was getting nearer, nearer, catching up with her. Then he got her, and with one gulp, swallowed her. In the meantime, Peter, without the slightest fear, stood behind the closed gate, watching all that was going on. He ran home, got a strong rope, and climbed up the high stone wall. One of the branches of the tree around which the wolf was walking stretched out over the wall. Grabbing hold of the branch, Peter lightly climbed over onto the tree. Peter said to the bird, "Fly down and circle over the wolf's head. Only take care that he doesn't catch you." The bird almost touched the wolf's head with his wings, while the wolf snapped angrily at him, this side and that. How that bird teased that wolf, and how the wolf wanted to catch him. But the bird was clever, and the wolf simply couldn't do anything about it. Meanwhile, Peter made a lasso, and carefully letting it down and down and down. Caught the wolf by the tail and pulled with all his might. Feeling himself caught, the wolf began to jump wildly, trying to get loose. The other end of the rope to the tree, and the wolf's jumping only made the rope round his tail tighter. Just then, the hunters came out of the woods. Following the wolf's trail and shooting as they went. Sitting in the tree said, "Don't shoot. Bertie and I have already caught the wolf. Now help us take him to the zoo." And off to the zoo they went. Listen very carefully, he could hear the duck quacking inside the wolf, because the wolf in his hurry had swallowed her alive.